Lady of Guadalupe, Spanish Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe, also called the Virgin of Guadalupe in Roman Catholicism. The Virgin Mary in her appearance before Saint Juan Diego in a vision in 1531. The name also refers to the Marian apparition itself. Our Lady of Guadalupe holds a special place in the religious life of Mexico and is one of the most popular religious devotions. Her image has played an important role as national symbol of Mexico. According to tradition, Mary appeared to Juan Diego, who was an Aztec convert to Christianity, on December 9th and again on December 12th, 1531. During her first apparition, she requested that a shrine to her be built on the spot where she appeared, Tepeyac Hill, now in a suburb of Mexico City. The bishop demanded a sign before he would approve construction of a church, however. Mary then appeared a second time to Juan Diego and ordered him to collect roses. In a second audience with the bishop, Juan Diego opened his cloak, letting dozens of roses fall to the floor and revealing the image of Mary imprinted on the inside of the cloak, the image that is now venerated in the Basilica of Guadalupe. Please all stand.
Likewise for the living of this. God, thank you and your Son Jesus. Very careful for the poor and the humble, to host yourself with all. With the people of the Americas, we honor you today and ask you to the suggestion of Mary to give us a deep respect and concern for all these poor and little, and to let us be in your caring hand. And this we ask through Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
already from the way of celebrating the Lord. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said to her, "Rejoice, O highly favored, the Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by his words and asked herself what his greeting would mean. But the angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid, you have won God's favor. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him a throne of his ancestor David, who will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his name will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about, since I'm a virgin? The Holy Spirit will come upon you." The angel answered, "And the power of the Most High will cover you with his shadow. And so the child will be holy, and will be called Son of God. Knowledge through your kinswoman, Elizabeth, passed. In her old age, herself conceived a son. And she will call Berlin, is now her 6th month, for nothing is impossible to God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said to be done to me." And the angel left her. Brothers and sisters, the gospel of our Son. Today, brothers and sisters, we are celebrating the Solemnity of Our Lady of Guadalupe, 1531, December 9, for the first time of Blessed Virgin Mary, a birth of a simple farmer, Juan Diego, in Mexico. And according to the legend, this person, which is a simple farmer, at the age of 56 to 57, was married and he didn't have a child, was on his way for the Holy Sacrifice to the Mass. And suddenly, in a place, in a mountainous place, in Tepeyac, Mexico, he was able to hear some sounds. And so, a bright light, and there and then that Mary appeared to him in a vision. And the simple message was to erect a chapel or a church in a place of apparition in Tepeyac Hill in Mexico. For the first time, when he confided everything to the bishop would not believe it, or hardly believe it. So what the bishop was telling, unless I could see a sign or signs that indeed the apparition was authentic, I would never allow the chapel to be built in a hill. To ask for short, 3 days after, when this person, Juan Diego, was trying to escape them on fulfilling the vision, on his way then, especially looking for a priest for the time his uncle was very, very sick, again, a Blessed Mother appeared to him on the center ground, 3 days after 1531. Another time, Juan Diego confided to Blessed Mother that Blessed Mother, our bishop wants to see a sign that this apparition is authentic. So what about Mary did was to let him or know that please take roses and show these roses to the bishop that indeed this is authentic. And it was winter time and roses could hardly grow at that time, and then the miraculous tree grew and he was able to pick some purple roses and put it on his cloak, on his tilma. And he was going to the bishop, and indeed he was ready to show the bishop the sign that indeed the apparition was authentic. Then he let roses fall from his cloak and tilma, and when he opened his cloak and tilma, and when the bishop saw what was inscripted in his cloak and tilma, then he knelt down for the Blessed Virgin Mary's figure was imprinted exactly on the tail of the cloak of Juan Diego. And after that, his story found, and it has been venerated since 1531 until the present. Even Juan Diego was proclaimed as a saint by Pope John or the Saint Pope John for the sake. So, brothers and sisters, what could we possibly reflect then on this very beautiful image of Our Lady of Guadalupe? It speaks to us that Mary is the first and foremost disciple who has given herself especially at the service of the Lord. And you please realize this December is a time that Mary has shown herself that she was immaculately conceived. And exactly 4 years after the global immaculate conception was proclaimed, her apparition then endures from Jupiter in suburb. It's a very touching experience of how Mary then becomes a part of our journey as Christians. Not just an example for us to emulate, but the first disciple who listened to the word of God. And of course, Mary's prominence happens to be she is the Theotokos, the one who carried our baby Jesus in her womb for 9 months. This is precisely the motherhood of Mary, the Lord always struck us in terms of discipleship, as her famous Pietro tells us, Lord, how could this thing happen to me since I don't know man? And yet, you will already be done. So, brothers and sisters, we try to commemorate then the number of years that the apparition of Blessed Mary to a simple person, farmer, in 1531 in Mexico. Let us remember also that a Blessed Mother appears himself to us daily in our own personal journey, especially when we recite our devotion to the Rosary, our Blessed Mother is there. When you are in hardship and in trouble, our Blessed Mother is there. When you are down and out, our Blessed Mother is there. And hopefully, this apparition is merely recalling or diminishing the past, but relieving, reminding our now dear mother. Our mother was begotten her son in the womb, and our mother becomes the first and the foremost disciple. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God sent Elijah and John the Baptist to remind the people of their need to change the way of life, and especially he has sent a blessed mother for us to emulate. This must be Lord, hear our prayer. The Holy Father and the bishops of the church may inspire people to trust in God amidst life difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord. And those who are struggling their faith experience and recognize God working in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord. Let parents and teachers be passed to the faith to the young people over time with a witness and example. Let us pray to the
Lord.
Once again, let us pray for those people who are needing for prayers, especially for those who are celebrating their birthdays, for Nicky Milan and Pansion, for TGK. Also for the healing of Minatres, Victor Pizuela, Francisco, Lidia Rodriguez, Michelle Picarellos, Ernesto Presidente, Jean Carlos Sal, Pelosan Mexico, Leonardo Rafael, the Petrimer, and for those who have died presently, Lulita Kaganan, Lourdes, Ola Kutiva Nasochati, Bartolomeo Kaganan, Cristalder Silvano, Fernandez, also for the souls of Unidas and Miami, Romaldo, Marina, Seta, Adelina, Rodrigo, Anastasia, Tobili, Gipati, and Seguro, and all souls in the Fernandez. And this we ask in Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
The mystery of our
faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and the resurrection
until
you
come again.
Therefore, as we see the memorial of the resurrection, we offer you our prayer tonight on the celestial salvation, giving thanks to this world to be in your presence and blessed to you. Humbly we pray for the blood of Christ, to be able to unveil the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your service to the world on bringing the fullness of charity, that friends of hope, the intercession with brothers and sisters on those dependent ministries. Remember also, brothers and sisters, for thee in the hope of rights and all thy mercy. Welcome them to the light of peace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, the blessed redeemer of God. We bless you, the spouse of the blessed apostles and all the saints, for our peace and joy and angels. We merit to be cursed in the night, and we pray to be found through his Son, Jesus Christ. To him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever. Thank you. Friends, these days, Lord Jesus, the Lamb of God, protect your sins of the world. How happy are we to partake of this
Lord.
Thank you. Anticipation of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who gave us your Son and Savior. We rejoice in the saving love of Jesus. I am the loving care of Mary. May we be faithful to him, may we engage in justice and service, and praising you with songs of joy. In this we ask for Christ.